Oh, hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I'm just doing this lab for one of my subscriber. He just sent me his account to me. Yeah, so Vishal Sao, he's just talking this particular lab for level one. He has completed almost he has completed almost every lab except at 10. Only this challenge lab and this payment will lab is left. So I'll complete this lab for him. So little favor, no problem. I'll be happy to help. So let's start this lab. I don't know why he's not able to complete. No problem. Maybe sometimes the rocker. So no problem. Let's start it. So let's wait for 5 minutes. Okay, so it is now done. Just wait for 5 minutes and it is done. So let's sign in. Here is the password. Use your email and password which they have provided in this. Accept it. So he is from, I think, India. So in my account, yeah. Okay, so okay, I will change the country here because I don't want to make any problem with him. Maybe there will be no problem while receiving the gift. Okay, let me select his country, India, and then continue. Okay, so this will be done now. So now let's read a little bit. Okay, so this will have requirement Chrome and text filter request. Okay, good. Okay, let's start the lab. It takes approximately 25 minutes to provision. So, but we are just waited for 5 minutes. No problem. This is the navigate to this. Okay, click this link. So it, this is the first link. It is written to open it. So let's open this. Okay, navigate to this. I'm logging here using. Because we are already logged in. No problem. Okay, now click accept. Yeah, it is done. Nice. Okay, let's activate the cloud cell. So here is the cloud cell. Now activate it. Just click it, it will activate. And minimize this stuff. Okay, click on this continue button. Okay, let's wait a little bit. So what is this message? Excuse me, never follow this project. You want to find anything? Please log into API.com. Okay, let's try. Let's try this if it works. Okay, this is done. Bring this down here. Okay, once we have created, let's run this some codes. So these are some basic codes. Sorry. Okay, click on subscribe. Okay, this is done. And this is also done. Now let's remove the extra body of your student. General password in the parent is okay. But this is the same where we are just right now. Yeah. But even open this link. Maybe you are just getting this because you want to send the link. So don't skip anything. Now test the window startup. So how to test it? You go to the compute engine. Not even, let's go to the compute engine. Okay, so dismiss it, don't activate this. Test it here. Open the first link. Okay. let's wait a little bit. Maybe the billing portfolio. What is this? I can see it. Why is asking for billing? You're not going to pay any money for this work. The guy switched to the second one. I mean, the first one we have just opened. And then the first loop. Let's see. Okay, so this is done here. Yeah? I'm not close this. Add this also. Now this is asking for billing. I don't know, just close this guy. Okay, see this code. It's going to work itself. So yeah, it is here. It's ready. That's nice. And the speed of stuff is maybe take a few minutes before it taping the instance. Okay, so make sure guys go to get at least this instance. If it is not in your panel, so wait a little bit, as they have mentioned, you need to wait a little bit. That will be good. Instance may not ready to accept the RDP connection immediately. Okay, nice. If you're using Chromebook machine, download the file, move in simple directory add the file and login using the reverse password. Okay, copy and paste RDP client. Okay, leave this. Then you want this a little bit. I need to do this guy. Okay, press the CRP open in Chrome and found the desktop of this and navigate to. Okay, now click this. Let's see. No FBA subscription is not for this new project. I will login using this credentials. Next, copy this password, paste it here. Next, okay. So this is done now. Yeah, just because something that we have missed, and just log in the field account. Make sure you log in with this account, okay? The account which they are providing this simple tab, okay? So this is done. So this is, that was the basic operation. So everything is correct now. Now we'll work for this part one. Okay, so let's read this. Okay, so this is the documentation. First, open some browser. Okay, let's save this file. I will save this file in another video. This. Okay, so this is saved now. This is just URL to save that file. Next, it's not ready logged in. So yeah, but we are just logging for this step. Now develop API proxy. So this is the develop API proxy. Click this. First click on the develop, then second click it here. So once this is done, click create new. So click this create new. Okay, now click use open API access this. Yeah, it is here. So click it. And now, okay, so it is a file. Let's upload that file. Here it is. It is under this video folder. It is here. So select, click on select. Let it there. Good. So once it is done, so here is the name. Copy this name and paste it here and copy this stuff and then into the base, move this and paste it. Good. I am testing. Okay, so copy here target listing API. API target, so replace this good. Now click next. Okay, the pass through notification, pass through notification, yeah, we selected. Now click next. So this is already selected. They might say to select it, yeah, good. So click next. Let me subscribe. I know I have done this 11 million times. So this is done. Now click the create and deploy. So let's wait a little bit. Once this is ready, we'll click on init for XP. Okay, so this is ready. Now let's click this init for XP. And let's wait a little bit here. Okay. Now let's read configuration. We have now built a API for XP for existing backend service. You should see this checking proxy overview. Wait until this set of deployment says to continue evaluation to. Okay, so we need to wait for this revision to be ready. Okay, so keep waiting on this particular screen admin window. This status will be changed to revision 1. So I think this will take about 20 to 30 minutes. So let's wait 20 to 30 minutes and after that we'll continue. Okay, let's wait. Okay, so finally after 30 minutes, so this is ready. So revision 1 is ready. So let's read more. So once it is ready, before we navigate to admin environment group and group verify that host name is sent to admin. Yeah, no need to verify, just like this. Navigate to debug. So here is the debug. Start debugging this again. It's working. If the debug is start, let's try this. Okay, so we connected. So this was 30 minutes. I mean, it will be longer time. So this is disconnected or cloud is disconnected, so let's disconnect it. So let's do it and we need to run this code. Okay, so this is related to the time. New tab. Close this. Let's start it from the beginning. Yes, this. Yeah, this is done now. Let's copy this code, paste it here, press enter. Good. Okay, don't worry about this. And navigate to develop. So this is develop. And click on export version. Okay. So this is the revision export version 1. So this file number, okay, so ignore this stuff. Okay, so let's check the first part. So this is done. So guys, let's move to the task 2. So in task 2, the scroll is already down. We develop API for XP, here for XP, click on develop. So you are already under develop, so no need to go anywhere. So select the first endpoint. So at the endpoint and the flow state. So here on the log tab. Yeah, this is the scene point, this is the pre flow. Click on this plus icon and select verify API key. Now then select verify API key. So scroll down a little bit, select this verify API key and they have given the name. So copy this name and paste it here. Sorry. So this is the name and okay, different name is set correctly. Click on the save button. So this is done. So once this is done, don't worry about this. Click on the save button. So where is the save? Where is the save? Click on the save button. Okay, good. Same division as true. That nice. Make sure guys you also get the same output. Okay, click on deploy to evil. So now click on deploy to evil deploy. And let's wait. So let's wait a minute or a while. Let's actually will environment. Okay. Deploying evil to. So let's wait a little bit. So once it is done, click on the debug, and select evil 2 and start debugging here. So good. So it is correct now. Now complete this code and run it here. So good. That nice. So remember this publish API product. So now click on Publish API product and then click on Create. Now click on this Create button and copy this name and paste it here. Okay, display name and paste it here. And here is the description. The description in the public, give it public, and in the drop down section, select API product. API resource, click add operation. So, this is API resource, click add operation, select on the second one. And what about the path? And create this wildcat and that's it. And click save product. Click the save product. So this is done. Publish developer. This is done. Okay. So publish. Click on the developer. Okay, so on the developer, click on this plus. Okay, so this is the name. Copy this name, paste it here. This is the last name, paste it here. And the username. Okay, and paste it here. Here is the email. Copy this carefully and paste it here. Click on create. Close this here. Click on create. Okay, so this is done, I think. Now, publish it. So, the end of the publish, click on this app. Tab. Click on plus F. And tag this name. Of this name and of this name and the display name, the display name, select developer previously created. Select this developer and click add product. Okay, click a product. It's created. We just created the product here. Let's select it and click add product. Okay, so select the product is not in the list. We just created the product. So it is. Click once again. So let's click on the box. So let's create once again. Once again. As I remember, I have to get here. No problem. Let's create it once again. Public access and scroll into the down, select this product dash sign, click on the save and also scroll. Okay, sorry, I forgot to save this product. Okay, so now it is saved now. So click this and click on this end. So scroll down and then developer is done. Now let's go this further. Copy this name, paste it here. Copy this display name, paste it here. And so let's developer. And let's pull up. Yeah, see this. Now it is here. So make sure it's saved correctly. Click add product. And this is done. And this is done. Now click on create. So click on this create button. Okay, so this is done now. Now we need to API for XP, we need to debug. Okay, API for XP. Open second one. Okay, select so debug. Here is the debug. Start debugging. No problem. Now let's copy this code. Just here. Just enter key. Did I miss anything? Okay. One last condition. Okay, don't worry about this code. Let's check. So it is done. Now let's move on to part 3. Okay, API publish. Publish the API product. And click on create. And here is the name. Copy this name. Test it here. This display name, check here. This name, check here. And let this. Do I need to add anything here? Okay, quota 3. Go to add quota 3. Request interval every 1 minute. Select 1 minute. Accept. Made operation. Okay, that's simple. Select the second one and call the test. That's it. Okay, guys. So make sure you upload this. And now, scroll it up and click on the set product. So this is it. Now, again, let's do this same thing for number of items. So click here once again. And let's add this. Okay, Not our quota. So on this left, then quota at every out every 1 minute. That's number one, left left, under this, under that type, soil card. I think this is the backwards left, and that's the backwards. So now let's scroll up, click on the save button. So this is save now. You can create the doc once again. You create and then type this name and also this display name. Sorry, so copy it, paste it here. And then here is the description. Put it here. Okay, good. Now select it. The public, what were the quota? So it is 100 request every 1 minute. So this is every 1 minute. That's minute. That's good. Click on add operation. Select the second. Type this backward slash. Click save. And scroll up. Also click save. So we have to click save 2 times. So this is done now. Now go under this F, click on the F icon and click on the F. And now tab. The display name. And choose any developer if it is there. And go select. Bronze product first. So here is the bronze. Select it. First we have just created that. Look. Click on create. So this is done. Now again click this create product. Click on add product. And we have to do the same thing. Copy this name. Paste it here. And the display name. Remove this. Paste it here. Yes, select developer and also this is I think silver. Yeah, silver, click add, create. So this is done. Again click it. Let's add new. Copy this name, paste it here. Copy this. Display name, paste it here. And send this, let this developer. So I think this is now gold product. Let's stop taking it. Let's send this one go. Click it in, click it. Okay. Deluxe. Okay. This name was not requested. Let's copy this name. Replace it carefully, guys. Save it. Not the error. Okay, so everything is done. It is cool. Let's create now. Okay, nice. So everything is done now. Now develop APIX. Okay, now we will click on the developer tab. Click Apex 2. Let's open it. And under this develop tab, click on the develop tab. Okay, good. We are under the free flow now, correct? We are under already free flow. Click this to check left quota. Select quota, drag the quota name on this. Quota policy. No quota. That is the quota policy. Here is the quota policy. Let me check. Select quota and type quota policy. Paste it here. click add. Click add. Now this is done. Now what will do? You have to click on the save. So scroll here, click save. Okay, so this is done. Now click deploy table. So this is done. Check the tar product. Go to the developer tab. Debug tab. Let's click complete. Let's go. This is working. Let's test this. So the error log number 3. No error. Now let's see another. So this is something nothing to be worried. So let's check our code path. It is okay. See, everything is correct. You guys say always that how to do this. So easy. You don't follow any step. If you mistake, if you do any little mistake, you will get the error. So follow everything correctly, guys. So we are under part 4, build an app developer. No problem. Just notice, guys. Okay, click this link. And okay, so guys, end of the video. I will just say, nice. Develop the paper XP and develop the paper XP. Good. Then click revision. Okay, that's the block. So what is the revision? And what next? I will import it to the import revision file under this video. And this is the file I think now. Just say the name. Click on upload. Okay, so this is done. Now click deploy to even. Okay, click deploy to even. Click deploy. So let's wait a little bit. To do the sound this will be from. Sound this file will be from. Okay. Device this file will go. Okay, let me check this file first. Click on this device. Right. Let's click once again. Click on the save. Okay, still it's name 1. No problem. Do this name. Let's save. Okay, so this is done. To do this, download this file with an index editor of the choice. Replace that name with the file name. Okay. So we have to edit this file. This is simple, just open the notepad. Just open this notepad and put this file here. And what we have to replace? We have to replace in line with this. So copy this name. And here it is. Let's check, is it in your mode? No, it is only there. Okay, so let's save this file and close it. So this is done. Now publish portal. So click on publish. We are under the portal. And okay, and what? Click on get it. So click this. It asks for name. So here is the name. Copy this name. Paste it here. Now we go to description. So copy this description. Paste it on the description. Click on create. let's wait a little bit. Okay, guys, so this is done, I think. Good. So this is done. Now click it, pick it along. And here it is. Click this plus icon, where it is here, very tiny plus icon. And select bronze. So we are under this bronze. Click next. And what we will do here? Make sure to check publish. Okay, so we have to check this publish. And after that, select open. Okay, so we have to select. Okay, select and open API. And we have to put that failure. Okay, we have to put this file. Open this application. So click this. Start the video. Yeah, this is the file. Open it. Specific name. Okay, specific. And then you click on anything. Click upload. And register user only. Change this to the register user. And select this name. So, copy this URL. Copy this link and select image URL, type this here and click select. So this is done. Click save. So very simple, very simple. So click the save button. So let's go to it. Okay, so I think this is ready. Click on this live button. Let's see if it works. Okay, so nice. Everything is correct. So once this is done, you can click sign in button here. Yeah. Click sign in button. And okay, we have to create a new account. Create an account. So click this create an account. And let's fill the name. Okay, guys, I'll fill the name. Okay, so I have filled this detail. So I have used my detail. You also use your personal email ID. You can't use this one. So let's click on this create account. Okay, let's check our email. Okay, check my email. Okay, so here it is. Now click this verify link. Okay, good. So it is now verified. So I can close this account. Let's go back here. This is private one. So this is done. Now once again, close this and click on this live portal. Now we have verified our account. Now we can sign in. So click on the sign in button. Type the password. Okay, this is done, I think. Good. So this is done. Provide the details and click create account. Everything is done. This is done, I think. Good. Okay, so once this is done, click API, click this link, good, click a product, if you click on this execute, it should give error, yeah, send error, so now navigate to the API, to this API, create new API, so click on shutdown. Let's copy this name, paste it here, copy this product description, that cell. Once this is done, scroll it down, click it enable, and it is a bronze. Now click it save. Okay, so this is done now. So once it is saved, this is our key. Okay. Now navigate. Okay, catalog. Okay, we can just skip this. Let's check out progress. Okay, come on. Okay, so this is done now. So this is the final. So we are moving for the step 5. It will take 15 minutes. No problem. If you refer to the whole watch this video, give you some metric test. No problem. So click on this analyze. Okay, just skip this. And we will start from the creating a report. In order to create the report, must create a. We have to do is open it from browser and log in using this. Okay. So click this link. Yeah, this one and this one will take, no problem. Even just open it, no problem. Once you open it, let me close this one. Give this one and upload the cloud layer. Okay, this is this. And now paste it here. Press enter key. Click authorize. Okay, so this is done. Okay, good. Okay, now add drag as a policy product. So it is develop API, here it is. Develop APIs. And open this one. And under the develop tab. Under this develop tab, get product details. So click get product details. Okay, get product details. So next here you just click the get product details. Click this process step and extract variable. So scroll down. Okay, here is extract variable. Here is extract variable. And then okay, good. Click add, click this head, now click this, get product details, click plus, and what is it? Data capture. Okay. So click once again, scroll down, and this is a data capture under the extension, and click on it. No need to change the description or name anything. So click save. Click save. Okay, good. And once it is saved, click deploy it. Okay, so it's in the data. Okay, don't worry about this. Let's try once again. Validation error. Required data collector dot com does not exist. Okay, don't worry. Just ignore this. Let's try this. Okay, so up to here we have done. Now debug, start the season, we are searching the season. Okay, let's try and improve. Then save it out. I think we need to change something here. Yeah, I think we need to change that one. So up to depth, that is good. Now analyze custom reports. Now click on analyze and click on the custom report. Click on report. Custom report, report, click plus item, click custom report. So what is the name? This is the name of the report. Type this name. This is the description. Copy this description, paste it there. And select line type to chart type. Okay. Chart type to line one, okay. Make sure you also do this. And format it, scroll down. Click this product, the traffic, and so click on form, click F. Okay, for dimension, click this, go to the custom, and I think developer again. As I remember, under this dimension, developer app, DC product, developer app. So this is developer app, DC product ID, DC product ID. Okay, so this is done. Click prepare under this header. Name is 4xp. So scroll down little bit more. Like this 4xp. Operator first one equal to what was the value. So this is the value. Click this carefully, paste it here, click it. So this is done. Now you can save, click the save button and wait a little bit. So the report is I think ready. Okay, let's check. Time, so don't worry, we are going to complete this. Okay, so finally this live is completed. So my friend may be happy, this will do favor for him. So hope he is happy. Okay, no problem. I'll be ready to help. Let's submit this lab and don't do that option. That is up to work, so not worry about that. So let's see what is the lab. So we have remaining. So see, lab is completed. We are just stopping this lab. So nice. So we have left this lab. I'll come to this lab. This is for easy. Not worry.